Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today we are going to talk about how to directly integrate with Facebook conversions and Facebook lead forms to fix the iOS 14 issue, among other things. And we're going to do this in 5 easy steps. So let's get started. Okay, so why you need this, just really quickly, in case you haven't heard, you probably have, but the iOS 14 update is going to negatively impact your ads and reporting because when the users upgrade to iOS 14, they're going to be prompted to opt in to tracking on their device, and most people are going to click no. So that right there is going to severely impact your Facebook pixel because basically anything that they do is going to be untrackable. So what you can do if you're using high level is set up a direct connection to the Facebook conversion API. And I'm going to show you how to do that right now so that you don't lose your tracking data. So step one, what you're going to do, if you don't already have high level, you can sign up for a free 14-day trial using the link below. So you're going to set up everything and then you're going to go into workflows. Okay. So you're going to go to workflows and we are going to create a new workflow. Now I will add the quick caveat here that you do need to have a Facebook lead form set up and integrated with high level, and I have another video on how to do that if you don't already have that done. So if you need to do that, click the card to go do that really quick, pause this, and then come back later. So what we're going to do is we are going to click to create a new workflow, and we're going to start from scratch. Then we're going to click on create workflow, and we're going to add a trigger that is for a Facebook lead form submitted, and then we're going to click on save. Okay. Then here on the action, we are going to create a Facebook conversion API. And don't fret about this. We're going to actually do this right now. So we're going to go ahead and fill in the details. So I want you to open a new window and go to your Facebook Business Manager. And you're going to see something like this. Okay, so you're going to go to your business accounts and you're going to click on Event Manager at the bottom, and then you're going to click on the pixel that you want to use. Okay, so step two, we're going to set up our test events, and we are going to go into test event here, and we're going to copy this to the clipboard. Now, this is only for testing. Once you go live, you need to remove this or else it's going to mess everything up. Okay, so go back into high level and paste the test code in there. And then step three, we're going to set up our conversion API. So we're going to go back over into Facebook and we're going to go to settings. And then we're going to generate underneath where it says conversion API, we're going to generate an access token. And then we're going to copy this. We're going to go back into high level and we're going to paste it right here where it says access token. Okay. And then we have another thing that we need to do here. We need to paste our pixel ID. So that's right here at the top. You can just click it to copy it to your clipboard, paste it in here. And for me, this is actually a lead. So I'm going to leave lead here. But you can actually set up any of the conversions that you want to set up here. And then the value, you can put your value in and the currency and then the test code. So we're going to go ahead and click on save and we're going to click on publish and then save. And I'm actually going to rename this Facebook lead form submitted. So it's not something random, and save it. So step four, we are going to test. I always test. You're going to go to the Facebook lead ads testing tool, developers.facebook.com/leads/tools/lead-ads-testing. You need this to make sure that it's actually going to work correctly. So what we're going to do is we are going to choose a page, and then we can choose our lead form here. And then we're going to click on preview form. And then we can click, we put in our information and click next, and then submit. So this is going to create a test lead form that we can then verify was created. Okay, so I submitted my lead ad, and now I'm going to go back into high level and check to make sure that my data was received. So I'm going to click on history, and you should be able to verify this here. So let's go ahead, and it looks like I was added to the workflow. I was added to conversion API and then removed. So I'm going to click on more events. And then here where it says user data sent to Facebook, you should see this information was sent to Facebook through the API, and it says success. Awesome. Okay. So step five, you want to remove the test code now that we've validated that this is actually working. We're going to go back to the workflows, and we're going to edit this, and we're going to remove the test code. Click on save. And that's it. So I hope that helps you guys to add the Facebook conversion API directly into your Facebook lead ad so you don't lose that important information and data with the iOS 14 update. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you guys next time.